Good afternoon, respected jury members. Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible.
Okay, I'm Gauri Devanand. Thank you for giving me an opportunity to present a topic on rising of online gaming and escapism during COVID-19. As we all know, the coronavirus pandemic has significantly disrupted normal activities globally. Stay-at-home mandates and quarantines have increased consumption of digital entertainment, particularly online gaming and related activities. Gaming is not necessarily problematic, and that for the most, gaming appears adaptive and may reduce loneliness. Moreover, gaming is typically less harmful than many other potential behaviors used to cope up with stress and aversive emotions such as alcohol and drug use or overeating. Gaming may also be relatively inexpensive for those already owning gaming equipment. As reported by a survey in 2021, the largest share of mobile gamers in India was constituted by men aged between 25 and 45 years that made up for 47% of the country's overall mobile gaming population. On the other hand, a major portion of female mobile gamers in India were found to be over the age of 45 in that period. As a whole, the largest section of India's mobile gaming audience belonged to 25 to 44 years age group in 2021. As I move into the next slide, what is escapism? It is a tendency to escape from the real world to a safety and a comfort of a fantasy world. Research evidence suggests that most engagement in gaming is of positive benefit, and that of benefits can be educational, physical, and therapeutic. Gaming can also help in developing cognitive skills such as reasoning, spatial awareness, and problem solving. However, excessive gaming for protracted period can be problematic for minority of individuals. There has been much uncertainty and anxiety surrounding the present pandemic that has led even the most casual of players to seek refuge in online games, which allow them to escape monotony and connect with other gamers alike who share the same sentiments. People are looking for new virtual experience to make up for the real ones. They are lost due to most of the society shutting down due to the lockdowns. The growing wave of the interest in online gaming is evidenced by search engines, top searches, which people who search for game app growing over 100% in over a week, or test online games rising 100% annually. Next slide. Previous one. What is addiction? Gaming addiction is the compulsion to play video games to such an extent that it has a negative effect upon your life and being unable to stop even if you wish to. As with any addiction, it is fundamentally a disorder of the brain's reward centers, which creates an abnormal level of chemical, for example, dopamine, associated with pleasurable feelings in the brain. Addicts which experience an excess of dopamine when they play games, thus creating a sensation of happiness and well-being. And on the other side, they will suffer from a deficiency thereof when they are unable to play, drastically lowering their mood and over the long term causing depression. The World Health Organization has defined gaming addiction as a pattern of persistent or recurrent gaming behavior defined by three criteria. One is lack of control of playing video games. Second is priority given to video games over their interest. Third is inability to stop playing video games even after being affected by negative consequences. Gaming addiction can have highly detrimental effects on an addict's life, causing them to give up previously valuable relationship in favor of the isolation which gaming entails, and potentially having serious financial consequences, including the loss of jobs and accusation of huge debt to fund new games or in-game purchases. Next slide. The effects of gaming addiction can be pronounced and very negative. As mentioned above, addicts can suffer detrimental consequences on work or relationship, leading to isolation. Many gamers with profound addiction do not get enough sunlight or nutrition, leading to vitamin deficiency. They may also never exercise and eat plenty of junk food and eat high sugar, soft drink to excess. These can all have serious consequences for the health of the gamer. Obesity and complaints related to malnutrition are not uncommon. Sleep deprivation is a major factor which potentially severe effects on the addict's mental health. All the above can contribute to the development of a serious depression, including major depressive order. While each case is unique, what may represent problem gaming in one person may be unproblematic to another. They are experiencing any of the following. They may suffer from an addiction of gaming. One is thinking obsessively about gaming, even when engaged in other activities, losing interest in previously important and valued activities, going for long periods without sleeping in favor of gaming, having very fluctuating and unhealthy eating habits, trying to stop gaming but being unable to do so. Next slide. Symptoms. Because gaming is not a physical addiction, no physical dependence is created in addict system. Withdrawal symptoms are overwhelmingly psychological nature. Withdrawal can begin at any point after the last time an addict play a game, though if they are forced to stop, like if they don't have a power outage or an equipment failure, they tend to likely manifest some symptoms immediately. Symptoms include restlessness, irritability, aggression, mood swings, anxiety, and depression, all of which can manifest at any time after the last period of the gaming. Most prominently, the addict will feel intense craving to resume the playing and may become very volatile if kept away from the computer or game console. They may also find themselves suffering from insomnia driven by feelings of extreme tension or anxiety. Long-term depression may be a major factor and can even contribute to suicidal ideation, especially among gamers who find real life extremely challenging. Next slide. Like any other compulsive disorder, video game addiction can have severe negative consequences. Though most of the symptoms listed above have short-term effects, they can lead to more severe long-term effects if not addressed properly. For example, someone addicted to video games will often avoid sleeping or eating proper meals in order to continue gaming. While the short-term effect of this may include hunger and fatigue, it could eventually lead to a sleep disorder or a diet-related health issues. Similarly, those who isolate themselves from others in order to play video games may miss out on family events, outing with friends, or other events in the short term. If this continues to be a pattern for a long period, however, addicts might find themselves without any friends at all. Other long-term effects of video game addiction to consider are the financial, academic, and occupational consequences involved. Video games and video game equipments can be very expensive, especially when factoring in recurring costs such as high-speed internet connection required for online multi-gamer play games. These games can also be very time-consuming, leaving addicted gamers with less time to focus on their education career. As well as addiction, the following harmful effects have been found to be related to video game use: increased aggressive thoughts and aggressive behavior, particularly in children under age 10, increased risk of light-induced seizures, musculoskeletal disorders of the upper extremities, and increased metabolic rate. Research with people who are addicted to video games shows that they have poor mental health and cognitive functioning, including poorer impulse control and ADHD symptoms compared to people who do not have video game addiction. People who are addicted to video games also have increased emotional difficulties, including decreased depression and anxiety, report feeling more socially isolated, and more likely to have problems with internet pornography use. Next slide. What are the reasons to make a video game addiction, or how can a gaming becoming an addiction? Hyperarousal also can be triggered by a release of dopamine, which is a feel-good chemical that's released in the brain when we experience success or achievement. It's the same dopamine release process that triggers addiction to video games, screens, and chemicals such as alcohol. An addiction is defined as an individual's inability to control use of a substance or behavior in spite of negative consequences and functional impairment in life. Many children and adults who engage in screen or video game used to exclusion of other normal activities fall dangerously close to meeting this definition. Dopamine is powerful. It helps sustain interest and attention, which is why it can be so hard for anyone to tear themselves away from the video game or interesting post on Facebook. It's self-reinforcing. The more interest we experience, the more dopamine is released, and the more attention we direct to the task at the hand, the biological process can lead to long-term or permanent changes in the brain that require extensive behavior treatment to reverse. And some of the other reasons are the most addictive video games have no predefined ends. This is one of the central features of massively multiplayer online role-playing games. Addictive video games feed a need to make social connections. Video games are more addictive when in-game rewards are based on a leveling system. The more addictive video games often encourage play and collaboration with gaming worldwide. Addictive video games often have some form of in-game currency. It is easier to view video games as harmless online activities. One important factor that makes video games addictive is that rewards often are set on variable schedules. The virtual world of addictive video games continues to evolve even if the player is not online. Companies regularly release upgrades or expansion packs. Top video game players or teams can earn real-world rewards. Addictive video games may allow the player to immerse him or herself in a fully realized virtual world. Next slide. The risk factors. Excessive online gaming can lead to physical health problems, including poor sleep quality, insomnia, cardiovascular disease, as well as vision and risk problems. While such psychosocial issues as stress, anxiety, depression, and decreasing level of life satisfaction can also occur. This systematic review aims to determine the predisposing factor responsible for online gaming addiction to become reference in the prevention efforts. Playing online games frequently can cause health problems, particularly addiction. Clinical distress can also appear in teenagers who often play online games. Bullying often occurs among game players because of their inability to play as good as others, which can make it harder for other players and lead to insult, intimidation, getting kicked out from the game, or having bad quality of sleep caused by decreased mental health status. Physical problems that often occur are insomnia, cardiovascular problems, vision problems, pain on the wrist, and hyperactive. Psychosocial problems such as stress, anxiety, indication of depression, and low life satisfaction can also be experienced. Next slide. Okay, the treatments are, some of the treatments are cognitive behavior therapy, which is a type of psychotherapeutic treatment that helps people learn how to identify and change destructive or distributing thought patterns that have a negative influence on behavior emotions. Next slide, next. Dialectical behavior therapy. It is a modified type of cognitive behavior therapy. Its main goals are to teach people how to live in the moment, developing healthy ways to cope up with stress, regulate their emotions, and improve their relationship with others. Motivational enhancement therapy. It's a counseling approach that helps individuals resolve their ambivalence about engaging in the treatment and stopping their addictions. This approach aims to evoke rapid and internationally motivated change. Next is acceptance and commitment therapy. It's an action-oriented approach to psychotherapy that stems from traditional behavior therapy and cognitive behavior therapy. Last one is psychoeducation. The goal is to help people better understand mental health condition is considered to be an essential aspect of all therapy programs. It is generally known as that those who have thorough understanding for the challenges they are facing as well as knowledge of a person's coping ability, internal and external resources and their own areas of strength are often better able to address difficulties, feel more in control of the conditions and have a greater internal capacity to work towards the mental and emotional well-being. Next is self-esteem. Self-esteem reflects what we think about ourselves. It means we esteem and have a good opinion about ourselves. self-esteem has a significant prospect impact on our life experiences and not the reverse. In the other words, high and low life esteem is not depend on our success or failure. Let me conclude my presentation by stating that the present review of the current perspective of internet gaming addiction has shown that research has progressed significantly over the last decade, leading to a larger evidence base, which includes important findings from neuroimaging research. Further, it indicates that contextual factors play an important part in our understanding of internet gaming addiction as an holistic phenomenon. The holistic approach adopted here not only highlights empirical research that confirms neurobiological correlates of internet gaming addiction and establishment of a preliminary diagnosis, but also emphasizes the need for an in-depth understanding of gaming context and practices associated with the gaming. Ultimately, a holistic understanding will benefit individuals who seek professional help for problematic online gaming as treatment approaches becoming more targeted and consequently more effective. Thank you.